What's that smell? Pizza.
Got pizza.
Give me that.
Pizza. Wait, what do you want me to do?
Go.
I'm gonna leave it on.
I keep doing it.
Kobe.
He's doing it.
What's going on?
Grandpa, tell me one of your stories.
What? You want to watch Toy Story?
No, you old hag. I didn't say that. I said tell me one of your stories.
Oh. Alright, I got a good one for you. It all started back in the Nerf War of 2016. Right after Donald Trump became president. Me and my best buddy. We were ordered to take down a terrorist post.
Jay, you ready?
Yeah. Come on, let's do this.
Alright, time to break in.
What in the world is that? We're using this.
Have it your way.
Let's go. Ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three. Let's blow up the security area.
Oh, hi.
It's clear.
Come on, John, focus. All right, this is where they are, down here. Ready?
Yeah.
On three. One, two, three.
Ah! Jay, you okay?
Yeah, I'm gonna be fine. Come on, let's go.
Hey!
Shoot, they got backup coming.
Alright, that door right there, that's where they're hiding.
Alright. You go in there and I'll cover you, alright?
Yeah.
Ready? Go, 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 go!
What a wonderful world. See them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
John! Jay!
I see skies.
What, John? Stay with me, man. Come on.
You're my...
The bright, blessed day.
John! No!
Grandpa!
What?
Grandpa! Grandpa!
What?
You're just staring, not saying anything. I'm scared. Are you okay?
Must have had a nerve flashback.
Well, can you tell me the story?
Boy, who do you think you are talking to your grandpa like that? Boy, I
No, Grandpa! No,
what?
Grandpa! Please!
Get over
sorry.
Here!
I'm sorry! Stop!
I'm gonna whip
please.
You back to your mama's
please! What the heck? Stop!
You don't respect your life!
Sorry!
You don't respect your life!
Sorry! Sorry!
There like much more.
Don't hold it. Can't keep up.
And I never knew.
Oh!
What a wonderful
world. I even hate you, even though I still have
to.
Wait, let's see how it looks.
Before
the grams.
I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
All right, mate, I think it's on.
John Willard?
Yeah.
Oi, I'm Jack Johnson. Welcome back to African Wild Hunts. Today, we're looking for the wild man bear pig said to live in these dunes for us. All right, let's get searching.
What?
Oh, that was embarrassing. Never mind that. All right. The trick to finding the man bear pig is to look for the footprints. Now, the shape of the footprints, though, are shaped like a human.
Yo, what was that, mate?
I don't know.
What was that?
Mate! 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 mug him.
James, how many times do I have to tell you to leave the ball in the basement?
James?
Oh my gosh. No.
Just a dream.
James, you down there? James?
No. This can't be real.
No. Come on.
Thank you. major lift. The baffled king composing hallelujah, hallelujah. And it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift. The baffled king composing hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hey man, what's up?
Nothing much. Just staring at the trees.
We're kind of down. Something wrong?
My mom died yesterday.
How'd she die?
She had breast cancer.
Sorry,
I didn't know your mom had breast cancer.
She did.
You know, my aunt had breast cancer too, so I know how you feel.
April Fools!
What? It's not even April Fool's Day. It's like April 22nd.
Franz Ferdinand and they're like that getting killed, all accurate, great stuff. It's the best way for kids today to learn. And plus I said exciting and then an awesome teacher too. I know that.
Oh, did you see that sick nose globe of Arstuk Franz Ferdinand? Did you see that?
Mr. Anderson, I thought this was just a video game.
Last time I checked, I was a teacher.
I was just saying.
Very hard being a teacher, but I still do my job very well.
History is the first class of the day, so I kind of get tired during his battlefield lectures, and it makes me fall asleep. He really likes pulling pranks on me when I'm sleeping. I don't think he really likes me.
Jack, get the door, please.
Mr. Anderson forgot to do the attendance again. Can you tell him?
Okay, sure.
Hey, Mr. Anderson forgot to do the attendance again.
Man, didn't I tell you to take the attendance down today?
No, you didn't tell me to.
You're dead to me.
I don't know why Mr. Anderson takes everything so seriously. Last week, I joked that I was pregnant, and he said, "Thank God, I thought you were getting fat."
Hey, I like your shoes.
Oh, thanks. I like them too.
Same. They look pretty good, man.
I'm needing to grill them.
Where did you get them from?
The dump. That's where I get all my stuff. I don't understand why people buy overpriced clothes at the store when you can get perfectly free ones at the dump. I don't understand people.
I hate my life.
Has anybody ever seen a magnificent warrior appear to great in a movie called The Hunger Games?
Ooh, I've seen that movie. You know what another good movie is? White Chicks. Shows how Obama got the girls back in the day.
And that symbolizes white men's burden. Now you're catching up.
Okay, guys, that's it. Dr. Claus, we're having fun, so...
How do I feel about Mr. Anderson? Well, I wouldn't tell him that he's a bad teacher. That would be like being a doctor and walking up to your patient and saying, "Hey, you have cancer," but you just don't do that!
Well, all we do is watch his battlefield clips, and not a lot of work, so it's an easy 100. So yeah, I like him.
Throughout these last few weeks of history with Mr. Anderson, I've learned you have to be careful making jokes with him. He'll either not get it or get offended and kick you out of class.
Yeah, I like my Spanish teacher, Mr. Sun.
I don't know what my students would think of me, but I really think that I'm a handsome, fun man. I'm an awesome teacher, and I make life really meaningful to them. That's why I consider myself as a teacher, Mr. Anderson.
Have you ever heard of Battlefield 1? It's not gonna work, man!
What it comes down to, Nigel? Betraying your own best friend?
So, Nigel, found this map the other day.
Treasure map?
Yeah.
Do you still believe in that stuff?
Well, no, but I went to the first two areas, and they seem legit, but going on it seems dangerous. It wouldn't be wise to go alone.
All right. So many bugs and plants out here. Show more pants like you do. What do you think the price is going to be anyways?
Probably gold or something.
Gold?
Yeah, what else would it be?
You think this is a movie?
Well, I don't know. Could be. Could be an artifact. Anything. Just got to find out.
Adam, watch out!
You're a lifesaver, Nigel.
I know. that it?
Oh my god, Nigel. We found it.
Wow. I'm gonna open it.
Well? Nigel, what's in it? Nigel, what? Down to Nigel? Betraying your own best friend?
This ends now.
Nigel, please don't do this. Look what you're doing.
I'm so sorry, Adam. I don't know what got into me.
It's that treasure. Like possessed you or something. We weren't you.
This is real dangerous, man.
You gotta bury it, dispose of it, so that no one gets corrupted like you did. Nigel, this is...
It's morphing time!
Nate, how many times do I have to tell you we're not superheroes?
Oh, bro, this time it's real. Emil's just following me, man. I'm telling you.
Wait, you let him here? What the?
I'm here!
I'm out of here! Out the front door!
Oh, no.
Oh my gosh.
Almost heaven, West Virginia,
Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah
River.
Life is older than the trees,
longer than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home.
Day 23 since the world ended. As time goes on, it gets harder to find food, harder to keep warm as winter quickly approaches. 2 days ago, I left my home on a journey to find any signs of humanity every night. I can't stop thinking about everything. The nukes, the natural disasters, the chaos and famine. My father dying from trying to protect us from the purges, and my mother dying later on from disease. I have nothing left to lose on this journey, except for my own life. But as every day grows closer to my death, I still have hope. Hope that the world can begin again.
David, son, come here. I got something for you.
A box?
Yeah, but not just the box, what lies within the box.
There you go. There's your keys.
But the catch is you can't open it until your 18th birthday in 3 months.
I gave the kid the box so he could experience every human emotion. First, happiness. Then, curiosity. Soon would come frustration.
Dad, I can't take this anymore.
Anger. Sadness. And then, he would feel nothing.
Before I start my very thought out defense, I'd like to remind the court that Rose Quartz did turn herself in.
The court remembers.
Of course, innocent. The word innocent can mean, many different...
What the heck, man?
I did it!
Yo, I was just watching that!
I want to watch cartoons, dude. Storage Wars is on.
Who gives a flip-flap about Storage Wars? I want to watch cartoons.
Bro, really? Again? No one cares about this stupid, pointless, irrelevant show. I wanna watch cartoons! Steven Universe! Give me that!
Wait, no, don't.
Start one. The males taste the air and savor the scent of what will soon be their pride. But they don't attack.
I love my car.
my car!
Wow, action VFX are really good at making these effects.
Wait. This isn't real?
No, it's just effects. It's fake.
Hello?
Your brother didn't commit suicide. He was murdered.
Who is this? It's me, Zach.
Hey, Zach. How's it going?
Yeah, nothing much. I just got this weird phone call from some unknown number saying that my brother didn't commit suicide. I know it may sound crazy, but...
Okay, man. You gotta move on. Look, you have no job, you're living at your dad's house, and you lost your girlfriend because of that.
Yeah, I know.
I think it's probably just some kind of prank call or just paranoia or something.
You just don't understand.
My name is Zachary Rohart, but I go by Zach. I live with my dad and my brother, Aaron. I don't remember my mom. She died when I was little, so I don't have any memories with her. Life was good, until one day, my life would never be the same. It's been a year since my brother's death. It was no accident. It was no suicide. It was murder. And I'm gonna find out who done it.
Zach, how's it going?
Hey, Lucy. I'm doing better. Listen, I'm trying to find the guy who murdered my brother.
You think he was murdered?
Yeah. The cops may not have noticed, but I did. I did for sure.
Well, come on in. We can talk about it.
So, do you know if he had any enemies?
I mean, not really. For the most part, everyone liked him.
Did he ever mention anything to you about any problems he had with other people?
No. Well, actually, he told me not to tell anyone, but I guess it doesn't really matter now. He was having some trouble with gangs.
Gangs?
Yeah, there was this one gang in particular called the Whisperers.
The Whisperers? Why didn't you say something sooner?
Because I thought if I went to the cops, the Whisperers would find out and kill me too.
So, you think they killed him?
Well, yeah. Hey, have you checked Aaron's email? There might be something in there about them. Just a guess, though.
No, I haven't. That's a good idea, though. I can't believe I actually haven't thought of that, actually. Just like the rest of the stuff in his room, his computer is also off. I don't know. It just kind of felt weird, you know? Hey, thanks for all your help.
Anything for a Wolfhack. See you later.
See it happen to you, but I'm not gonna stop him from doing so. Mazes is a fair man. You know he will forgive you, Saber. Saber. Like a Saber. Overgrown Lane behind 5782 at 6 p.m. tonight. I have this.
You look like him, all right? You Wahar's brother?
Yeah,
Nah, man. I want to know your real name. I'ma just call you Scorpio, you know? Got a nice ring to it. You never know who could be listening.
You're Saber, right? I read the last email to my brother, and you seem to somewhat care about him.
Yeah, man. Me and him joined the game at the same time, you know? Got to know each other real well, know our in and outs. Anyway, let's hurry this thing up. You got questions, I got answers.
Did my brother's involvement in the Whisperers lead to his death?
Well, as you read in the emails, he You know, I warned him about his mistake, that he'll be after me.
He? Who's he? I read in the emails you mentioned someone named Bezos?
Yeah, he's the boss, you know. You cross him, he'll dispose of you. Well, not without his warnings, of course, but you play by his rules and he'll respect you.
So why do you care, Aaron?
That, you gotta take over Mazes.
How do I reach him?
Wait, you weren't thinking about confronting him, are you? I was just kidding, dog. I mean, like, you can't go up to him asking him
questions. I'm gonna do what I gotta do.
His number is 394-1700. I never told you. You don't know who I am. This never happened, aight? Well, hey, Scorpio. You gonna need this.
Remember the name Realheart?
Haven't heard that name in a long while.
Where can I find you?
Why's that?
You gotta talk.
Oh, we can talk, all right. I'll be waiting at the empty lot near the park whenever you're feeling chatty.
I knew this moment was gonna come. Somebody would find out the truth. I must say though, I'm not an easy man to kill. Whoa. If you're gonna go that route, you're gonna have to shoot an unarmed man. You'll be a murderer and spend the rest of your days in prison.
You're a murderer!
The society has rules. They must be followed. Your brother had many chances and warnings not to join us. We did anyways.
Empty your pockets.
No. It's not easy, is it? It's not as fun as doing it with your bare hands either. Let's see if you fight like your brother. Fight harder than that.
You think I've just been sitting around all this time?
Dirty.
It's been a while since I got my hands dirty. Usually my boys take care of my light work. I'll give you one more chance to leave. If you don't want to end up like your brother. Thank you.
Oh, shoot. Hey, babe. Nah, you didn't. I was already up. Yeah. So how you doing?
How's work been going? Work's been pretty good. Yeah.
Boys be cracking them jokes every day. Yeah, Steve, he's alright.
Nah, not really. I mean, my boss said he might give me a promotion soon too, so that's always good.
Oh, you gotta go? Alright, yeah. Alright, see you tonight. Yeah, love you too, babe. Alright, bye.
Scorpio. Been a while. You've probably been busy ever since. Well, you know. But lots have changed. I took control. I'm a big man now. And I never got to thank you for what you did back there. If you're ever in need of assistance, or a job, or a home, or anything, you know who to call.
Action.
Hey, have you checked Aaron's email? There might be some stuff in there about them.
No.
Just a guess, though.
Damn. Shit.
Hey, have you checked Aaron's email? There might be some. Hey.
Oh my gosh. Action.
Jesus Christ.
I need a bottle very quickly.
Damn, bro!
Jesus! Action.
Danielle, if you don't get this done, I will choke you so bad that you stop breathing and you die. Do you understand that? I'll murder you just like my brother was murdered. You better get this down. I swear to God, Katie.
Suicide. He was murdered. Your brother didn't commit suicide. He was murdered. Dang, do it again. Do it again. I gotta get this. Wait, is this still rolling?
Yeah.
Your brother didn't commit suicide. No, I'm kidding.
Recording. Okay. I gotta clean the lens. No, I'm just kidding. Okay. Rolling. Quiet on set.
Okay, it's game time.
Rolling. Action.
Hey, Mom, do we have any breakfast?
Do I have to shop for you, too? Get your own food!
It's a pretty rough life to live with. Disrespectful mom, poor grades, no friends. However, there is one trait about me that is unique to everyone else. I have the ability to travel to somewhere far, almost as if it's a different world, just by hurting myself. I know, right? I'm the only one here. It's kind of like my place of solitude. It's much better than the real world. I don't have control when I come back. I just wake up like it's a dream. But meanwhile, in the real world, I just seem sound asleep. I still don't understand the true meaning of this power, or even why I have it. But hey, I'm not complaining.
See me after class. Ken, when are you going to do something in class?
I'm sorry, Mr. Norris. I can't seem to remember anything from your lectures.
Well, are you getting enough sleep? Do you feel okay? Are you sick?
I assure you I'm getting enough sleep.
Do you need any extra help or anything?
No, I don't want to deal with that.
Well, you got to at least try to pay better attention.
I'll try. Can I help you?
Yeah. Do you remember what the history homework was?
Are you in my class?
Yeah, I'm Sarah. We've worked together.
No, I'm sorry. I don't remember what the homework was.
All right. It was worth a try.
I didn't really know what was going on with me. I may have a crush just based on that one interaction. I barely talk to any girls, and the fact that I don't remember talking to her irritates me. Maybe I'll see her again tomorrow.
Sarah.
Oh, Good morning, Ken. I was gonna say hi to you, but you weren't here, so I just waited for you.
Wow, I'm flattered. Holy cow, she really wanted to see me again, too. Did you get the homework all right?
Yeah, it's all good. All right, well, I'll see you in class.
Sarah, wait.
Yes?
Do you maybe want to go to the park tomorrow?
Yeah, I'd like that.
Great. How does one sound?
Sounds good.
See you there.
All right.
You know what? I'm not going back this time. Why can't I just have one break? One! I have a date to get to. I have a whole life to live. Get me out of here! Be late. She'll be understanding, right? She'll look at my pajamas and laugh, right? She won't hate me, right?
It's been a few weeks since I left rehabilitation. Not only did I have to practice walking after my legs were broken, but I had to bring my mind back to reality too. I never did go out with Sarah, but I think it's for the best. Ever since that day, I've never been back.